Precisamente, y hemos hablado entre todos para hacer también el sistema, o sea, continuar con el sistema comparativo.
Now, just not family history really, but I have a twin brother who's 7 minutes older than me.
You have a twin brother?
Twin brother.
Que tiene un hermano
There's two of me.
gemelo.
There's two of me. Yeah. Yeah.
Que es el mismo, ¿no?
And
7 minutos, más bien.
7 minutos. Ah, ves, yo no lo había entendido esto yo.
And I tell you, if I walked out and he walked in, you would think it was me. We're that much alike. Also beard, hair, even a slight bald patch on the top, right? And we're both left-handed the same. And we have similar wives. Both the names begin with J.
Que tienen mujeres similares.
So we're very similar.
Son muy similares.
Now the interesting point is, as I say, if he then walked in to join me and stood beside me,
que si él viene para estar a su lado,
I guarantee most of you would look at me, look at him, look at me, you would compare.
Exacto, que si se pone a su lado vas a estar mirándolos a los dos para compararlos y ver lo que tienen de diferentes o lo que tienen de iguales, o lo que, cómo son uno al lado del otro.
So, the comparative system is a natural human function.
Que es una función natural humana, el sistema comparativo.
Now the second thing about, I'll talk about the one system then the other, you see. Now, with the comparative system, you are only trying to achieve one objective.
Que con el sistema comparativo solo tienes un objetivo.
And that objective is to place the horses in order. 1, 2, 3,
que es
four,
poner
five,
los
six.
Caballos por orden.
And during the duration of the class,
durante la duración de la clase,
you can change the order because you suddenly see something.
Puedes cambiar el orden porque de repente puedes ver algo que no has visto en el minuto antes.
So it is,
en
if you
de
like.
En la clase puedes decir, no, es que ahora está segundo. En el papel te los vas.
Now all judging really depends on your first thought about the horse, and the second is a closer analysis of the horse.
Sorry, wait. Repeat again, please.
The judging is for me.
Y luego es un análisis más cercano.
Exacto.
Yeah. Yeah, there's two parts to judging, the initial response and your more detailed analysis of the horse.
Now, con más detalles.
And so it may be that the horse, when presented to you, has a nice flat back, but then you see it walk away.
Cuando el caballo se presenta bien presentado, le veis un buen top line, un buen cuerpo, pero cuando él camina.
So you can change your positioning according
to. Posición porque se ve diferente.
So here are some of the advantages. I'll add one last advantage, for me, one of the great things of the comparative system.
Las ventajas del sistema comparativo.
Usually one judge, sometimes you have two. Always a problem if the other judge is a very beautiful girl, because you always give way to them.
Sí, que si el otro juez es una mujer, que te puede distraer. Que os está diciendo en plan de broma, ¿no?
I admit to this.
Sí, que él admite esto, ¿no? Pero que aparte de esto.
But that basically, as I say, normally one judge. And so if you don't like what the judge has done, you know which judge is at fault.
Exacto, que es como solo hay un juez
for you.
Que si a ti no te gusta la clasificación de ese juez, puedes decir que ese juez no te gusta cómo está clasificando los caballos.
So don't ask him again.
Que le gusta al juez.
So don't ask him again. Right. So you don't ask him to judge again.
No, lo vais a llamar para juzgar otra vez. Así de
right. And if you look on the ACAJO list or on the English list or any other list of judges, you'll see many names you've never seen them judge.
Que nunca verás más el nombre de ese juez en la lista de jueces de ACAJO, claro.
Right, now to the point system, so to compare.
El sistema de puntos va a cambiar ahora para hablar del sistema de puntos.
The point system was first designed by ACAJO when ACAJO was set up.
Fue diseñado por ACAJO cuando
some 30 years ago or whatever
sí, 30
it was.
Años, hace 30 años.
Now the person, contrary to what some people say, the person who first set it up was a Ronald Kidd, who was secretary of WAHO at one time, until he and Jay Stream fell out.
La persona que empezó era la secretaria de WAHO,
yeah.
La Asociación Mundial del Mundo, de la persona que la creó.
And he was a brilliantly intellectual professor from Oxford University, you
él
know,
era un profesor
very brainy.
De la Universidad de Oxford, que pensaba mucho, ¿no?
So he came up with this system, which was a 20-point system.
Era un sistema de puntuación de 20.
Where your whole judgment was based on your ideal of a horse.
Que tú tenías que juzgar
the perfect horse.
Con el 20 era el perfecto, ¿no? The 20 was the perfect. Entre 0 y 20.
So you had to compare those horses in front, when marking them, with something in here. Yeah. So, but it wasn't the only point system. Sweden had another point system, which was 5 marks.
Que en Suiza, Suecia, hay un sistema de puntos con 5.
Yeah, and they were. Type was multiplied by 6,
tipo multiplicado por 6,
movement by 5, and the others by 3. And you ended up with 100. Yeah?
El total es de 100.
Now, the real irony is Sweden got rid of that system. Why? Because it was only 5 marks. Now, if you look at point system today, which is called a 20-point system, who sees a mark below 16?
O 15. Que el problema es que la puntuación de hoy, que teóricamente es entre 0 y 20, últimamente solo se trabaja entre el 15 y el 20, cuando la otra puntuación sueca tiene mucho más margen, ¿no?
Now, the system in those days was quite interesting, particularly in Sweden, because any horse who got out of 100, 85 and above, got a gold medal. 85% of the mark, it got a gold medal. If it got over 75% of the mark, it got a silver medal. And if it got 65% of the mark... Does everybody understand the idea?
Cristina, help.
El sistema sueco, que estaba sobre 100, cualquier caballo que superaba 65 era medalla de bronce. 75 era medalla de plata.
Vale.
Y 85 medalla de oro. Por el sistema que tiene el corrector de baremos.
Vale, vale, vale.
Now the advantage of that, the Swedish system, I just last thing about, is that if it was a very bad class,
si tienes una clase muy mala, nadie ya me lo imagino.
Number one horse may not even get a bronze.
No, no, exacto. El ganador no puede tener nunca ni una medalla de bronce porque no llega a la puntuación mínima para obtener una medalla de bronce.
But there was a well-known Swedish judge called Birgitta Fock. You'll remember Birgitta. And she had a very beautiful bay Polish mare, and she was eighth place in a big mare, a class of beautiful mares.
Había una yegua, la jueza tenía una yegua, polaca muy bonita, que quedó octava dicho en la.
And I went up to her and I said, oh, I wasn't judging. And I went up to her and said, oh Birgitta, I'm so sorry, I love your mare, only eighth. She said, Peter, I'm happy, I've got a gold. The first 8 mares were all gold. Now you see, we have nothing like that today quite. I mean, they talk about.
Ha desaparecido todo esto, que no hay nada de todo esto.
En la octava, y le dijo que qué pena que queda octava. Y dice, no me importa, porque he sido oro. O sea, las 8 primeras yeguas fueron de oro.
Tenían la puntuación tan alta, porque había mucha clase, y solo por la puntuación se merecían todas la medalla de oro, porque llegaban al mínimo para esa medalla.
So now to some of my criticisms, question marks, about the point system. One, it's a panel of judges. 3 for a sea show usually, 4 or 5, even more at Paris, but a large number, a panel.
El panel.
A panel of judges. Now, the problem with a panel of judges is the result isn't yours, necessarily. Your horse might have been only second or third. So, yet you get blamed with the result of the other judges.
Sí, que no estás de acuerdo muchas veces con los resultados de los otros jueces. Y resulta que las puntuaciones que tú has puesto no... O sea, que no están de acuerdo y que el caballo que tú querías como primero... No entra en...
And I remember judging at the Nations, not the Nations Cup, the European Cup at Hoogdensbosch in Holland many years ago.
De Europa en Holanda.
I think it was a 4th European Championship. In those days it moved around. And the stallion champion, the European champion stallion, was Balaton.
Ah, Balaton fue campeón.
Now, Balaton was a very good producer, I think.
Fue un gran productor.
Cobignac and horses of that quality. But when he stood in front of you,
cuando estaba delante de ti.
He had type.
Tenía tipo.
Appalling front legs. Very
like
bad.
Cubinet.
Yeah, very bad front legs. Yeah.
Que estaba muy mal de manos, de patas en general.
And he reminded me of an over-muscled man on,
era muy musculoso y
on some sunny beach. He lacked quality.
Ah, vale, yeah. Beach, vale.
He lacked refinement. You know, an Arab should be elegant, it should be refined, and he lacked that.
Tiene que ser elegante, tiene que tener un poco refinado.
So I actually,
es una raza.
My choice was another horse, but all the other judges chose Balaton.
Right? Pero que el resto de jueces lo dio a él por campeón.
And after the show, many people came to me and said, "Oh, so you like Balaton?" You know, and I said, no, not me, the others.
Claro, pues la gente le decía, oh, a ti te gusta Balaton. Y él decía, no, a mí no, a los otros.
So that's one problem of the... And sometimes, with the point system, and I'm sure Christina will agree with me, you will agree with me, you've judged all your class, the judges, the panel go to the edge of the ring, and then the announcer says, "The first horse, the winner is..." And you look at it. Wasn't my choice. Was it your choice? My choice. Probably it was everybody's second choice, and we all had very different first choices. So you end up with the first horse not being anybody's choice.
Que no es la elección nunca el que gana, porque no te lo esperas o porque la suma de puntos es otra.
Que puede ser el mismo repetido en el segundo puesto muchas veces, ser primero, y los primeros que han elegido los jueces no gana ninguno.
Exacto.
Los segundos y llegan a primero.
Exacto, que a veces no hay ningún juez que esté de acuerdo con lo que pasa cuando pones puntos.
Yeah. Now, the next point with the panel, I'm just dealing with the panel side of it at the moment, is that there are many judges, and I won't name them because I don't want to be taken to court, but there are many judges who sit in the middle of the panel just giving
17, 18, 19, 17, 18, 19.
They're not sticking out, you know, if it's a very good horse, 20. If it's a very bad horse,
you know. Si es muy malo, no le ponen un 13.
And so I call these freewheelers. You know what I mean, Christina? Like going downhill on a bike and you're not pedaling. They're depending on the rest of the panel to judge for them.
Exacto. Que el campeón o el subcampeón depende ya de los otros jueces. Hay unos que se quedan allí.
No se mojan.
Yeah.
No se mojan. Yeah. Entonces se le dice que es una como una rueda libre de las bicicletas.
But nobody.
Sí, que pedaleas, pero no te mueves de allí, ¿no?
But nobody gets cross with them because they haven't given a tremendous high mark or a tremendous low mark, and so they go on being asked, and yet they're not judging.
But, sorry, I am according with you, but sometimes if you make a lot of difference between the points, nobody wants you more, ¿eh?
Oh, I know. This is the problem.
Entendéis que a veces yo lo digo también como juez joven. Que he intentado a veces poner mucha diferencia, pero también con eso corres el riesgo de que no te llamen nunca más. Entonces, vamos un poco, we are a little...
Pilar, si te llaman a
juzgar,
tienes que juzgar.
Of course. Sí, pero ¿por qué no ponemos un 10? Si es de 0 a 20, ¿por qué no ponemos un 10?
No. Yeah. Now, the problems also I find with the point system is... that after all, judging a horse, particularly for things like type, not so much on legs, but for type, is a subjective matter, not a mathematical matter.
Subjetiva. Es el único punto, o los puntos de la tableta de puntos, que dependen más del juez que de unas normativas, digámoslo así, ¿no? El tipo es algo más subjetivo, exacto. No se puede... It's algo. It's something that is we cannot. What's the name?
Put a definite mark.
Exactly.
You can't define that
exactly.
Precisely. Yeah, and you know, then what happens as well is many people are at some little show up in the Arctic, that you know, top of Norway or something. Well, I know a case of a horse. It got 92, a 4-year-old stallion, in the very north of Norway. The owner was so pleased. They put it in a horse box, a trailer, in fact, and they drove it from the Bergen in Norway to Oh, the south of Germany, where they have the Egyptian events. Do you remember?
Una ganadera en el norte de Finlandia, en un campeonato, su caballo tuvo 92 puntos. Entonces se quedaron tan encantados con eso, que fue el caballo a Alemania, a un concurso de puro egipcio, pensando que tenía una joya.
Yeah.
I suppose they didn't have a jewel.
Yeah. And of course, they got about 15 marks lower, because it was a very high class show.
Alemania, que el otro concurso pequeño y tal,
and so, yeah, and so you find that the poor girl who owned the horse was in tears. She was crying her eyes out. And I thought my horse was a champion, and is not, you know. And there was an awful case in Jordan many years ago where both the national show and the Middle East Championships were using the same judges on the same point system. And one judge, that was again dear Birgitte Voch, she was judging in both for some reason.
El mismo juez a veces ha juzgado en el show de Jordania, el mismo, dos shows diferentes, pero se ha encontrado juzgando y el mismo caballo.
And she judged one horse in the national, and it got quite a high mark. A day later, the same horse
después, el mismo caballo, que el nacional, sacó muchos puntos,
got 11 marks less.
Que sacó muchos puntos menos en el siguiente show, que había otro tipo de calidad, entonces las puntuaciones.
The owner was understandably rather worried, so they quickly changed the system, and now the national is point system, and the other is top 10. But so it's another problem. For me, in many ways, the biggest problem of the point system, well, there are so many, but is one, this issue that the marks of all of you, particularly the older ones here, and most of you are young, but, well, younger than me anyway, but the marks are getting higher and higher and higher, and the gap getting narrower and narrower and narrower. Now, it is not achieving what the point system was set out to achieve, because the point system has two aims: to place the horses in order, but also to say something by the number of their quality, their standard. I think the two issues are incompatible.
Ayúdame, porque como he cogido el teléfono me he perdido un poco al principio.
El sistema de puntuaciones se hizo no solamente para puntuarlos y ponerlos en orden, sino que era también para hacer un estándar del caballo. Entonces, claro, si se están puntuando cada vez más alto,
claro,
a 20, 20, 20, ese estándar se diluye.
Volvemos otra vez a lo de todo es gold, todo es plata, todo es plata.
And the truth,
or perhaps the quality for a lot of people, the quality is more high today. That
oh, it is, ago. it is a bit higher, but not. upsets me about it, is that you, let's say you have a super mare like Pianissima.
Pianissima.
You'll all know Pianissima. Okay, now she gets, let's say, 94. She'll get a high mark. Okay, she gets 94. Now, in the same show, and probably in the same class, there's another horse that's pretty awful, and it gets 89. Only 5 marks less? This is ridiculous. There should be 20 marks between the bad horse and the good horse. Otherwise, it's meaningless.
Cinco puntos entre el peor caballo y el mejor caballo. Qué ridículo. Sobre 100, ¿eh? Estamos hablando... Sobre 100.
Y era un caballo excepcional.
Y era un caballo excepcional.
Pianísima, excepcional.
Pianísima, estamos hablando de uno que se merecía los 20, pero que en comparación con el otro, sobre 100, de la media total, tenían que pasar de 94 a lo mejor a 40 o a 50. Pero no solo entre Pianísima. Pianísima was near the perfect, ¿no? Pianísima entraba dentro del ideal morfológico, ¿no? Digámoslo así. Entonces, te encuentras pues con esta diferencia tan corta. Y dices, es que mi caballo ha quedado a 5 o 6 puntos de Pianísima. Cuidadín con esto.
Yeah. And you get this variation in marks from shows, because if you have a slightly good horse in a very bad class, you think, wow, thank God, you know,
sí,
one good horse, and you mark it too high. Whereas if you had that same horse in a very quality class,
que si tu caballo, sí,
you would be more critical.
Si tú tienes un caballo normal, pero resulta que sale en una clase donde no hay nada de calidad, te vas a creer que tienes... porque él se lo ha ganado a todos, ¿no? Y que el mismo caballo se entra después en una clase donde hay mucha calidad y tu caballo puede ser el último.
And I think I've said enough really going on about this, except for the last point I'll make is this. One of the great problems for me with the point system is you're expected to give 4 of your 5 marks, that's type, head and neck, body and top line, and legs.
¿Entendéis los 5 parámetros de puntos? tipo, cabeza y cuello, cuerpo, aplomos y movimiento.
Yeah. In about 1.5 to 2 minutes.
Que tienes dos minutos, los jueces tenemos 2 minutos para poner, este es el defecto del problema de puntos.
Yeah.
En 2 minutos tenemos que juzgar un caballo con todos estos puntos.
Mm. And the problem is that therefore those marks are given while the horse is being presented in front of you,
claro,
by the handler.
Que el handler mm-hmm. presenta el caballo enfrente tuyo durante 2 minutos y que depende también de cómo se presente que te puedan variar los puntos. And according with the handler, you can change the points too of the horse.
Yeah, well, so I mean that's why I like it when horses are shown naturally. But the point I'm making is that with many a good and clever handler, and there are many good and clever handlers.
Con buenos presentadores.
They can turn a horse with a short neck into a horse with a long neck.
Sí, que la alargan cuellos, que los pueden sudar.
And a horse with a back like a hammock.
No ves tampoco las que musculan los dorsos. Para que no se vean los dorsos.
So you're looking at it there for this 1.5 minutes. Mark.
Claro, que tenemos 2 minutos o 3 minutos para poner los puntos de ese caballo.
And the ringmaster then says, already, and you say yes. He tells the handler to walk away with the horse, and you see the horse has a short neck and a back like this.
Sí, que ya has puesto los puntos y cuando lo ves que deja de presentarse y empieza a irse, ostras, te das cuenta de que has puesto un punto que a lo mejor en una comparativa no se te habría ocurrido nunca.
And you can do it's too late, you can't do anything about it, you've put the marks down.
Que tú ya has puesto los puntos a ese caballo.
So what many judges are judging today is presentation, not horse. Yeah? Presentation, the way it stands. They're judging the way the man has put the horse rather than the real horse.
Yeah. Bueno, espera, ayuda.
Están juzgando la presentación más que caballo.
Exacto. Exacto. But if the sorry, it's a question only.
Yeah, yeah.
But if a cajo not change the rules for the presentation,
yeah.
If not change like 2 years ago the panda eyes and not change a lot of things.
Yeah.
I understand now.
I know exactly.
It's true.
This is a problem. But this is why.
No.
This is why I retire.
Sí, precisamente estamos hablando un poco de que mientras ese cajo no se cambien las normas or el cajo not change the points. What we can do?
Well, I mean, here we go into another field, really, which is not to do with the point.
Okay,
yeah, but the point system. But so I think you can. Sorry, after how long have I been talking? You'll see that I actually prefer the comparative system. to give a cajo its due. And I served on the executive committee for, I was on the commission for the first 20 years of it, and I served on the executive committee for 8 years. So I knew much of the inside working of a cajo. But we were asked 3-4 years ago, it was Nasamari, myself, Egypt, and Nasamari, Marek Traylor, myself, and Deirdre Hyde, to look into the problems of the point system.
Que tuvieron que hacer un estudio, ¿no? del sistema de puntos.
And the truth is, we could not come up with an alternative, because it was felt that in Europe they would, much of Europe, they would not be willing to accept the comparative system.
Que en Europa no sé, que no, la gente misma no acepta el sistema.
They like the idea of marking the marks down on their catalog.
La idea de poner las marcas en los catálogos.
They feel involved.
Están o sea, el mismo ganadero o propietario que lleva el caballo al concurso prefiere este sistema.
But after all, what are we here for and why are we judging Arab horses? Well, because we're trying to assess whether they're good horses and which is the best in the ring. In other words, trying to help improve the breed. We are not a circus. Hmm? You know a circus?
Circo, habla del circo.
Yeah.
Que no somos un circo.
Sí, que teórica, que los jueces intentan mejorar la raza, pero bueno, es el sistema que hay.
So my proposal to the to ECAHO was to have sea shows comparative, cheaper for the organizers, point system. Out of 20, but trying to use more marks for A and B shows, and a top 10 for champion shows. In other words, Paris European Championship
que
and
a
Nations Cup and Middle East
en
Championship.
Concursos grandes. El campeonato final se hace un top 10 de comparativa, que no se cambia la primera puntuación de las clases, pero que sí en el campeonato final ya se hace más comparativa de top 10, ¿no?
So I hope that probably answers between the two.
En los shows pequeños
sean comparativos, que primero es más barato para los organizadores.
Ah, eso sí.
En el fondo es más honesto.
Ah, eso sí. No vas más arriba creyendo que tienes un caballito y no te
dejas. Entonces que los shows C fueran el sistema comparativo.
Que debería ser, pero
if just onto another subject, and it might be relevant to judging today, what am I looking for? Right, I put myself on the line. What am I looking for in judging a horse, an Arab horse? First of all, I'm looking for a horse that looks like an Arab. Now that might sound a stupid question.
No, but it's the type.
It's type.
No?
So
que
type.
Lo primero que se mira o que mira él como juez es que se vea que es un árabe.
Now, if I'm using the point system,
está juzgando caballos árabes para un concurso árabe y tiene que ver que es un árabe.
But type is not just a dish head.
Pero que no es solo el tipo. Que no está solo en la cabeza. Que no es el dish de la cabeza. Cuidado con esto.
I used to go and live with the Bedouin a little, with the Rowala tribe and the Beni Sakha tribe, and I asked. There was a marvelous old man. It was 1990, the year 1990. And there was a man who was Sheikh Abdullah, who was very dark, and I discovered he was born in 1900, so he was 90 years old, all in his Arab gear, only about this tall, very little man.
El árabe que conoció era muy muy pequeño, pero era muy árabe, era muy mayor de edad.
And he was the standard bearer, carrying the flag,
in
the Arab revolt with Lawrence of Arabia. Yeah, and he could not read or write. He could not read or write. So this was very important because he couldn't read from, say, a book written by Judy Forbes or
sí,
me
que
or.
Él no estaba, sí, yeah. Que no lo ha leído en ningún libro.
And so I asked him. First of all, I was stupid enough to ask his age. Right.
Que él le preguntó la edad.
And he wouldn't tell me.
Que él no quería decírsela, ¿no?
But he then told me that he was 15 years old at the beginning of the Arab Revolt.
Que era 50 años, 50.
Yeah.
A 15 años más viejo yeah. que el principio de la revuelta.
And he had killed 6 Ottomans with his sword.
Que él mató 6, ¿qué?
Ottomans, Turks, but Ottomans. anyway, so I was able to work out his age because he was 1915
that
the revolt started. Now, they brought north with them from Mecca over 70 horses that he was able to describe to me in 1990, although it was in 1915 that this took place.
Que él fue el que le describió
a 70 caballos desde
70
la Meca.
Caballos desde la Meca, sí.
70 años antes.
Sí.
Y a los 90 años le describió uno por uno los 70 caballos que trajo de la Meca.
Now, I'm not suggesting that you should all be illiterate like him, but most people who cannot read have got very good memories.
Que mucha de la gente no tiene hoy memoria.
No, dice que no sugiere que seamos analfabetos.
Ah, sí, sí,
que no te, la gente que vale. No puede leer yeah. tiene muy buena memoria.
And so he was able to describe me to me, as I say, nearly 70 horses. They didn't give them names. He would say their strain.
Ah, and la strain yeah. la línea, ¿no?
And,
él no sabía el nombre de los caballos, pero sí las líneas.
And claro. either color or markings or what they had
Hay
done.
Unos colores y unas marcas de cada animal de acuerdo con la línea o con la genética, ¿no? Es de genetic.
Yeah. So one mare who was she was a Cahillat. She
una yegua era
and chestnut.
Cahillat es Cahillat, ¿no?
And chestnut. Yeah.
Cahillat,
we always over there name them after the female, not the male, so it's Cahillat rather than Cahillan. But you know, that's just we call them that. Yeah, yeah. But and this mare called Aisha, she he described other than her color and her strain, by saying that Talal, the cousin of Emir Abdullah, had been his horse had been killed, and so He jumped on behind the rider on Aisha, and she carried two men from the battle.
Que él no la describió por...
Físicamente.
No la describió físicamente, sino por la historia, ¿no? La historia en las luchas o en...
No, que el caballo de Abdala mataron en la batalla,
sí.
Y que esta Aisha,
yeah.
Abdala, y llevó a los hombres.
Y la, exacto, exacto, que esta yegua, por su fortaleza o por su carácter de...
Valentía.
De valentía, exacto.
Anyway, to get the main story, but I then walked him around 240 horses at the Royal Stud in Jordan and asked him to say what was good or bad.
Now, 200 caballos en el show de Jordania, ¿no?
This was very interesting.
La gente también pregunta que cuál es bueno y malo.
And I asked him to name all the points, and I could have brought with me a big picture of a horse with all the Arab names on it.
Yeah. Sí, por los...
The Arabs have no name for a dish.
Que los árabes solo preguntan, dish es el perfil.
Because they don't think it, they don't, they say some have, some haven't. It's nothing, not important.
Que el resto que el actual is today, this has happened today, no?
No, 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 no. This was this man going around describing how the Bedouin felt. And the thing he kept on about very, very strongly was short back, short back, short back, short back. I mean, time after time, short back, good horse, bad horse, long back, short back. And
que el dorso tiene que ser, tenía que ser corto, que era la cosa más principal que había. Que no fuera largo, que fuera corto.
And the other point he said, the features of the Arab horse are easily expressed by each end. The head and the tail.
Ah.
Because he put a very important point on the tail. As soon as a horse moved one pace, the tail was lifted and carried high without ginger.
Pero sin jengibre, sin picor en el que no le metáis nada en el culo.
So and as far as the head was
artificial, que tiene que ser el levantar la cola natural. And eso tiene que ser de la árabe.
And as far as the head was concerned, his major, I haven't got. Can I find a piece of paper? No, I can find an envelope. You'll be able to see enough. But I can lean on that. I mean, his main point with the head was not, as I say, the dish, but it was.
Que lo importante de la cabeza
the
no
fact
es el perfil,
of a wedge shape.
Sino la forma triangular.
Now, if I just
cabeza.
Draw the head into that roughly, you'll see what I mean,
mira,
even with a slight dish.
Mira, ahora te os está haciendo el dibujo para que veáis cómo con un triángulo.
Very broad.
El perfil así, como
broad here, very fine here.
Que tiene que ser muy ancho aquí y muy estrecho aquí.
The eye, at least a third of the way.
Que la cabeza se divide en tres partes y que el ojo tiene que estar situado en una de las terceras partes.
And two things I think not everybody thinks of in Europe. One is the under jaw, except if they've got teeth problems, you know.
Sí, que esta línea
straight,
tiene
not
que ser recta.
Not
aparte doing that. De que sea la edad de los dientes,
straight.
Esto es otra cosa. Pero que cuando ya haya mudado los dientes tiene que estar recto la parte de aquí.
And if the horse is just resting and not excited and blowing its nostrils, the nostril should lie parallel to the face.
Y que la nariz, cuando el caballo está de relax en el box, la nariz tiene que estar paralela.
Not on the end like that.
Exacto, no para yeah. arriba como está, como yeah. como ha dibujado mm. aquí, sino que la nariz tiene que estar paralela, o sea, lateral,
yeah.
no para arriba.
Yeah. Now there's other two more wedges. Wedges,
dos
angles
más, dos
in the head.
Más en la cabeza. Frontal. Os está dibujando
frontal.
Frontal. Es un rombo. Ahora está dibujando los ojos.
Mm-hmm. Two wedges. The ears quite narrow
you
together.
Papers,
oh yes, and the ears, preferably with some,
que las orejas
not too. Not like a mule.
No tienen que ser muy largas.
Not too straight.
Que tienen que ser and more in males than in females, no?
Mm?
In females is more accepted than the
a slightly longer ears in a female.
En yegua se permite que sean un poquito más largas, pero que las orejas tienen que ser si pueden estar incurvadas hacia el interior.
And you know they always say and the muzzle, small enough to drink from a coffee pot.
Now, que pueda beber café.
Well, if you haven't seen, if you haven't seen an Arab, if you haven't seen an Arab coffee pot, it's even smaller than that. So it's a bit exaggerating, but yeah. But
yeah, es una manera de hablar, you know, pero que es un poco el ideal, ¿no? Que el morro tiene que ser muy refinado.
And if you just incidentally, it's by the by, really, but I was once with one of the Saudi princes with my brother. It was his blood brother, and we arrived for a luncheon, but we had coffee before, and the man who made the coffee, he was usually a Sudanese slave, and he made the coffee, and they bring it, and it first goes to the prince. But he has a row of the, like this, he has a row of the cups. It's not very hygienic,
que
by the
way. Que tenían, bueno.
He has a row of cups like that, you see, and he'll rattle them, and he has a coffee pot in the
y
other hand.
Con unas copas de, con unas tazas de café.
So first he offers one to the, you must only pick it up with your right hand. I'm left-handed, big problem. But and he gives the cup to the prince. The next one he gives it to is the most senior guest. Well, there was my twin and I. My twin is 7 minutes older. So the Sudanese says to the prince, and the prince laughs because he says, which one do I give it to next? And then when he comes around again, he will look at you. And if you want no more coffee, you just go. If you do want some more coffee, you hold it still. Once you, if he takes it because you want no more, he takes the cup back and he puts it on the bottom of the pile. Now, by the time he gets to the seventh man, he's drinking from the same cup. So it goes around and around. But anyway, that's nothing to do with Arab horses. But
I'm sorry.
No, Arab horses there. But you know, that's all to do with the formation of the horse at each end. Again, a subject that sometimes I've been asked, is it bad if the horse cocks its tail to one side? Absolutely not. Many Arabs cock their horses. There's a Swiss judge who says they have a fault in their spine. Twisted to one side.
No. See, no, I don't know why. This is something that I know.
Stallion.
Yeah.
Esta carries it to one side.
Stallion. Semental. Dejando claro, we see, that is a stallion, no problem.
Oh yeah, good. But many.
Lateral.
I think it's just one of those individuals. We are not all the same. They're not all the same.
Que no son todos lo mismo.
But I know a Swiss judge, I wouldn't name him, he says, no, it means that there's damage in its spine. I do not believe this at all, and nor do the Bedouin. So, but another interesting point while I'm looking at the back end of a horse is you'll notice I've drawn it like that. So the hips are very high. What you should not have from the back of a horse is that. Even if the tail is up, you don't want low set hips with a high peak in the middle. It should be high hips.
Que tiene que tener la articulación de la cadera alta. Que el, visto desde atrás no tiene que tener. Yeah.